quit school when she was 17. Senator on TV calls her welfare queen. Used to be daddy's little girl. Now she needs help in this mean old world. Buys cassette tapes in the bargain bin. Loves Carlene Carter and Loretta Lynn. Tries to have fun on a Saturday night. Sunday morning don't shine too bright. It's welfare music. Watch the baby dance to the welfare music. Will she ever stand a chance? Make three, but one ain't here. Still chasing women and drinking beer. Says nobody understands how he feels, but that don't pay them monthly bills. Angry fat man on the radio wants to keep his taxes way down low. Says there ought to be a law. Angriest man you ever saw. Dance circles on the floor, round and round just like before. Baby fall down, baby get up. Baby needs a drink from a loving cup. It's welfare music. Watch the baby dance to the welfare music. Will she ever stand?
Yo, Jess, man, I think you better go check your boy, man. I heard it was a slow suffer, man.
Word up.
Got your oven
Everybody come and get your welfare check. Come get your welfare check. Come get your welfare check. Everybody come and get your welfare check.
Service announcement. This is where the taxpayer money goes. Where the taxpayer money goes.
Ooh, a bugger in my nose.
We all share chonies and socks. Didn't mama check come in the mailbox?
All you have to do is fuck. And 9 months later, you're getting a big buck. But all you have to do is fuck. And 9 months later, you're getting a big buck. All you have to do is fuck. And 9 months later, you're getting a big buck. But all you have to do is fuck.
It's free! Swipe your EBT!
They money, they gon' kick your butt
at the county building.
Standing in line.
It's too late. They not passing out any more vouchers for Section 8.
It's too late. They not passing out any more vouchers for Section 8.
They turn me away.
All you have to do is fuck. And 9 months later, you're getting the big bucks. But all you have to do is fuck. And 9 months later, you're getting a big buck.
Oh my God.
All you have to do is fuck. And 9 months later, you're getting a big buck. But all you have to do is fuck.
What?
And 9 months later, you're getting a big buck.
Bust
a
nut.
Damn. Swipe
it, bitch.
Swipe your EBT.
Swipe it, bitch.
Swipe your EBT.
What?
Swipe your EBT.
You want me to bust a nut?
You had me to get it all.
Hey.
You had me to get it all.
Hey.
You had me to get it all.
Hey.
You had me. Get it all.
Right.
Y'all need to be sitting here now. Man, let me go get this
subway. Hi, kiddos.
house for session 8?
Because I don't want to go to Granny House anymore. Anymore.
Want some airheads?
Oh my God. All right, all right. That's enough. What? What's up, Negative Nation? Welcome to a Negs Live production on hashtag Stay Pause, a subsidiary of hashtag Stay Negative, which is owned by the conglomerate that is formerly known as the artist, formerly known as the Anal Booster. I am your Section 8 bully. It is 10:10 a.m. Eastern Standard Time here in the beautiful state of Indiana. Welcome to the broadcast. It's so good to see you this morning. I'm the Section 8 bully, baby. That's right. Don't even play. See, that's my name right there. I'm the EBT bully. I'm sorry. I'm the EBT, the bully. I'm EBT, the bully. That doesn't even make fucking sense. That's not what I put. I have dyslexia. Hang on a second. It's the third time I've changed it. The Section 8 bully. That's my name. I'm the Section 8 bully. Okay. Guys, be sure you share this out. I don't have a community tab yet. Be sure you sub up the channel. Today I'm going to be featuring a young lady known as Hiding My Moonface Jefferson, more like hiding period. She had some choice words for myself and some of the beautiful, wonderful, intelligent, successful, not on Section 8 ladies of the Negative Nation. So I know she's a little salty because she wanted to bone me not too long ago. She was on my Instagram saying she wanted to sleep with me. Her words, not mine. So I don't know how all of a sudden, you know, I'm unattractive. The ladies who like me are unattractive. Everything I do is bad. It doesn't make sense. How do you go from wanting to fuck someone to condemning them overnight? By the way, guys, if you really want to support the journey on the internet, go to thenegativenation.com and check out the Patreon page. I would encourage you to do so. All right. But here in a second, I'm going to pull up this lovely young lady's video because it is a hoot. It is a hoot. First thing we got to do is we got to switch sides. Of course, it's completely in the dark. Okay. Can we just point out, I just want to point out all the, just, this is so much BS, man. This is so much BS. Like, I don't understand. It says last shit talk of the year. Honey, they don't even show dislikes anymore. I'm showing you right now that I disliked your video, though. You have your comments turned off and you're in the dark, insulting people's looks. Like, and there's, you know, I haven't even gotten into this. I'm just going to paraphrase you a little bit and go ahead and roast you on it. You had the nerve to say that somebody was desperate for attention. Are you for real? You know that when you do one of these videos, I'm going to put it up on this screen and I'm going to react to it, right? You know that. That's why you did it. So who's really, truly desperate for attention there, Shaq? You want to tell us that? I like the nickname Shaq, by the way. I know you're not a fucking monolith like Shaq, but, you know, it's still befitting. She's trying to appeal to Ron. Ron and Negs are the same person. Negs, okay, let me, people who know me know the difference. When I'm live, like, am I Ron? Yes, but am I also this character Negs that people have created online? Yes, that's me too. There's not a very clear distinction. It's just a matter of me being on or me being off. All right. She's trying to appeal to my more human side. And remember her last video, she said that I was mentally ill and I was having problems and I needed help. And yeah, I did have a bit of a crisis and I'm dealing with the repercussions of that. And that's none of anybody's business. If you're not going to help, fuck off. Right. But how are you going to flash forward a month, you know, and be like, it's trying to dunk on people. In particular, you also, we're going to get to that, but I want to correct this right now. So I don't have to wait for the clip to pop up. Silvana has never used the words chomo, pedo, or made any accusations towards anybody like you claim in this video. See, Shaq, this is why you have your comments off, is because you know, this is 100% sad fishing. This is your way of sad fishing. You're going to chain smoke menthol 100s on your toilet in front of your fucking Section 8 light that could light up a surgical room. I'm talking about hiding my moon face Jefferson, Shaquana Jefferson. She really does not like peanut. I bet my video gets more views than yours, hon. I'm just saying. And I'm not even real of it. Oh, yeah. And she's also going to delete everything at the end of the year because we've had time to see it. We're that special, guys. She left it up for a whole year for us. Goddamn, we're so lucky. We are so lucky. I mean, this woman, she has blessed us with this. I can't believe it. We're unworthy. We are not worthy, my friends. By the way, if it's your first time here, if you're offended, did you know you can fucking watch something else? Yeah. Did you know that you, if you're offended by something that you found online, it's because you subjected yourself to it and it's your fault? Try not to be so goddamn stupid. All right. We're going to take a look at this. Last shit talking of the year. I'm going to play it at normal speed. How many people we got over on the Rumble machine? 11. Yes. Okay, cool. Great. Fantastic. All right. Don't need that anymore. By the way, if you want to chat, we're going to chat right here on YouTube as long as we can. All right.
It's been a nice week break from YouTube. I've gotten all of my holiday stuff.
A break from YouTube. You act like this is a job for you. Who has to take a break from social media? I never understood that. If you have to take a break from it like a fucking job and you don't make any money at it, maybe you're wasting your time. Maybe you need to go out and get a real fucking job and stop sucking off of the local taxpayers and the state taxpayers and the federal taxpayers.
Done. All of my gifts have been bought. They've been wrapped.
With what? What did you buy gifts with? I got to know this. I got to know how. Look, I know how I bought my gifts. Yeah.
All of my baking and things like that is going to be done tonight and tomorrow.
Wow. Look at you. Wow. Welfare really allots you a lot of flexibility to be quite the Susie homemaker. I'm impressed.
Do to prepare for Christmas Eve at my mom's is stop to liquor store and then go grab some eggnog and a salad at the grocery store. And
why does anyone need to know any of this laundry list of mediocre fucking this mediocre checklist of bullshit somebody's got to do? Who cares? Nobody cares. You did this again. I'm already going to rebut you on saying somebody else is desperate for attention because you did this for attention.
And then that is it. And then after this video, I'm going to be taking another break till the beginning of the year. I've got my year-end purge happening in my home. I go through all of my stuff, my animal stuff, my fridge.
Yep.
And throw away all of the old condiments.
You do that once a year? Cool. Cool. I clean my fridge out like once a week. So, yeah, I don't wait till the end of the year. I'm like, hey, is it day 364? No, it's 362. Fuck. Why? I can't clean the fridge out until day 364. And that's even a cheat day.
All of my dog's toys, I go through one by one. I gauge her reaction to them. If she doesn't seem interested in them, I give them to her sister, Ellie Mae, or I throw them away.
Stop. You guys were kidding. Oh, bless her heart. What is this? Oh, honey, you need a J-O-B. I hear it every day, 50 times a day. Okay. Also hear how I'm going to prison for being white. But hey, listen, you need a J-O-B. Okay. That's it. It'll do you some good.
Felix is going to get a new cat box, new water dishes, new toys, new food bowls and things. I'm going to buy him a new cat tree. So all of that old stuff needs to go.
Well, did you know on welfare, you can afford to have not one animal, but two animals and buy them new shit every year? Did you know that? Did you know that? I had no idea, dude. I swear to God, people are always like, you're on the welfare. And I'm like, am I really? What gives people the impression that I am on the welfare? That's what I want to know. Because this individual is not only admitted to it, but they kind of wear it like a badge of honor.
Go.
Because that's the climate that's been created in our country now, is that mediocrity is worth celebrating. Like, what the fuck?
Goes for Nova. She always gets a new water dish and a new food dish every year. even though I don't throw her leashes and collars out because they're very expensive.
Do you have a cold or did you just snort something before you went live? Allegedly. Let me say allegedly. Because your speech, I'm detecting some inflections in your speech and you're sniffing. So I'm assuming you either have a cold or you just railed a big old fucking oxy off to sink. I don't know. Well, I mean, if you're on welfare, you can afford these animals and all this other shit, right? And I'm not just pointing this at you. I'm just saying in general, people who are on welfare, right? You could probably afford some oxys.
I always buy her a new one every year too. So I've got a lot of stuff that I have to go through in my home, not even including my own personal stuff, like my clothes, my products and things.
Oh yeah.
So I'm definitely,
you got a lot of shit for somebody who's broke. Like how you ever like look around at the end of the year at all the bullshit that you're purging of your house and go, oh, I could probably have more if I didn't buy all this bullshit. But you know why people do this. They accumulate so much shit, right? It's because the money has no value attached to it. Money has been devalued to a whole generation of people in this country.
Definitely going to need another break from here until the beginning of the year.
And a break from what? A break from what, dude? What is she? Is she like the Cape Crusader? Is she the hero we need but don't deserve?
And hopefully I'll be able to go live. I actually activated it early this morning. I was trying to do a test run earlier, and I made a community tab saying, like, if you see me live, I'm just testing it to see if it works. And because this is a new channel, and well, it's not new at this point. It's been here for a year, but I had never activated the ability to go live through my console until today. Okay. On my old channel, yes.
Oh, that's right. That's right. You have to take a break to go play video games, like Nova, right? You two get together to play, like, what, GTA? And bitch about the... A bitch about the white man holding you down or something. I don't know.
But this channel, no. And it takes 24 hours for it to work. So I was not able to go live, which is why I deleted that community post pretty quickly. But now I know it's...
Somebody was sitting on top of your community post with 713 subscribers going, where'd that go? I'm sure they ran right to Twitter and was like, oh, did you see her delete that community tab post? I can't believe this. This is a scandal.
Most likely going to work at the beginning of the year. So I'm looking forward to that. I'm not sure how many times a month I'm going to do it, but it's definitely going to be something that I haven't done in a very long time, was be able to go live on my own channel. It's going to be awesome.
My God. What is this?
So I figured...
So you figured you would tell us 2 minutes and 17 seconds of information that nobody... that we could all live without knowing. And then now you're going to start trying to roast me and my community because what? Because... Look, man, I'm going to tell you something. I don't fuck with phony motherfuckers, okay? I don't. As soon as I caught wind of all y'all being fake on that fuck shit, yeah, I bailed. I exiled you because I before have forgiven people and just been like, oh, but they got problems. Look, I don't have time for your problems anymore. I got my own mental shit going on. I got to cope with that. I got to deal with that. I got my own problems. Like, you know what I'm saying? I don't need... people like yourself and Nova and I'm just going to leave it there. And these other people like being glad, like fair weathered friends, they're glad handing when you could do something for them. But as soon as you have your hand out, they're gone. Right. And that's the type of people that you are, is you care about what looks good, not about what's right. You care about how you feel, what looks good, and fuck everybody else.
Because I'm going to be taking another week long absence.
Oh my God, you have mentioned your break four times. Four times. It's like, what are you taking a break from? Guys, can you tell me?
Today was a good day, or yesterday in this case was a good day.
Well, okay. Whatever.
To like catch up on all the YouTube drama that I've missed for the past week.
Oh, yeah, it makes sense to take a break for a week and then come back and consume it all in one day. Yeah, that's great. So this is what you do, Shaq. As you come around, you run your mouth, turn your comments off, turn your ratings off, and then you retreat for a week, right? Is that what you do? Like, what's her name? Deactivating her Twitter once a month and cleaning it up because she's threatened everybody within a 3-foot circumference?
All of my drama-related videos that I've put in the Watch Later playlist, I watch them all. And then all the other stuff...
Who has time to do that? Oh, yeah, welfare recipients.
...that I was missing, I ended up just going to get... all of my info from Kiwi Farms, like screenshots and shit. I know probably half of you cringe every time I say Kiwi Farms, but I've never.
Yeah, because Let me tell you something about Kiwi Farms. Screenshots is about as good as it gets, because really nearly 90%, not all, 90% of the contributors there are there to suck their own dick and try to out edge the previous poster. That's it. And call people retards and the N word. That's it. That's it. It's nothing more.
Or denied the fact that I've gone there at least once a month for the past like 5 years, because even though I do know that there are some people on that site that are liars, they just make shit up, they stalk people, they've said and done some despicable things to my family. I do know that there are some other people there that just document stuff that there's physical, tangible proof of. It's screenshots. It's not a.
I don't trust a single one of those motherfuckers on there. They did that to me years ago, so they got that out of the way. All they could do now is be like, oh, next, I didn't like what he said. That hurt my feelings. That's it. That's all I ever hear anymore. And look, I know at least two people I used to fuck with that I don't anymore that are farmers. I'm not going to out them. I'm not going to out them, but I know who the fuck they are. I'm not dumb. I remember one time I was like, yeah, it'd be great if the farms would get a hold of this, you know, because I had a sneaking suspicion. Guess where it ended up? In an hour and a half, as to not seem like it was too eager. You know what I'm saying? It may have even been two and a half hours, but I said, ha, I knew it. I've been new, motherfucker.
Opinion. It's not them talking about something. It's actual screenshots. And that's what I go there for, because I'm not on Twitter like that. I'm not on other platforms to get any information. If I know that I'm interested.
So you're well, if you go to Twitter, you're only going to get a Marxist view of the world anyway. So fuck Twitter. So you go to Kiwi Farms. Once you sift through the numerous N-word, autistic, and retard comments, then yeah, you eventually get to a good screenshot and a point.
Interested in something, but I don't have
access. Nobody's really concerned. Like, I rag on Hater Nation. I used to. I don't give a fuck. They're just a bunch of dummies anyway. They're individuals. They're not an entity. But nobody is like, it strikes nobody as weird that the farms is basically like the areas that we frequent. It's a bigger site than this, but I mean, the areas that we frequent, nobody's thought that maybe these motherfuckers are feeders for a hot minute. Like, they talk about Angie Lee. Who is it? No, I mean, like, I get it. She's a locale, but like, come on, man. There's a point where locales are, they just, what the fuck? Everything they do isn't interesting, dummy. Like, you're entertained, but there's another aspect why you're there. It's either you have a morbid curiosity about unattractive fat people, or you're, I mean, I don't know. If that's the case, that's cool. Just say it. I like fat, ugly chicks.
Access to it. I always know to check there. So that's where I ended the night last night, was Kiwi Farms. I had a couple pages to catch up on. And boy, what a fucking treat that was. Some of the pictures that I saw, what a fucking treat. So,
what a treat. Yeah. Anything to make you feel better about not having any 401k, state provided insurance, state provided housing, state provided food. Imagine if the system collapsed. Guess who's, well, I don't know. You'd probably be one of the first ones to actually thrive, because you'd bow down before the machine so they wouldn't crush you.
We're going to start out light. And I'm just going to say that I'm unsubscribing from Amberlynn and Becky in 2022. Becky, it looks like she's lost a little bit of weight, which is great, but her content is not what I thought it was going to be.
So you're going to wait till 2022? What the fuck is this?
I was expecting and kind of hoping for more videos like her video called Rituals. And since that never happened, I'm on something. I wish her the best. Great. Hopefully she loses weight.
Yeah, I'm sure she was losing sleep over what you thought about that.
But the Q&A stuff and the cave, that's not any content that I want on my timeline in 2022.
No, but you'll gladly go and fish the farms for some negative-ass shit. You'll gladly sift through the R-word, the N-word, homophobia, transphobia, racism to get a screenshot, though, right? But you don't want that on your timeline. You don't make any sense.
Not interested. As far as Amberlynn goes, it's pretty obvious based on the last week that 2022 is going to be the year for her to milk this whole girlfriend thing for views.
Leaks
all about this girlfriend over the last couple years.
I don't care about fat girl drama. I want to hear what she's got to say about other stuff.
I can't fucking stand people like that.
What?
On to some of the valuables that I found on Kiwi Farms.
There we go.
The first one, speaking of failure, weight loss failure. Fucking on program, man. The pictures that they shared on Kiwi Farms, I got secondhand embarrassment and I cringed.
Yeah, you know what the secondhand embarrassment for me was you sitting in front of that light that you couldn't do anything about because you're not a homeowner.
The fucking nerve of you to still look that big. You're double my size to talk all that fucking shit.
How big are you? I mean, that's only fair that you, if she's double your size, you have your camera off. Need I remind you, you have your camera off talking about somebody's looks. Well, I'm no ops fan, but fuck me, dude. Be fair.
About these bitches on Twitter, still to this day, looking the way you do, being an absolute fucking failure yourself. You've got a lot of nerve.
Okay. I guess this is fat girl drama.
Fucking talk shit about her multiple times over the last couple years.
With your comments off. With your ratings off. Everybody has to make a video to clap back at Shaq here, guys.
I can't fucking stand people like that. Every excuse in the book is valid when they're the one giving it. They can be sick. They can have an eating disorder. They can have mental health problems. But when anybody else does it, those pigs, those buffaloes are the first ones there in line to capitalize on somebody else's fucking failure.
You're not wrong, but who fucking cares, dude? Have you not taken a fucking finite look around? You have to really, you know, not even fine, you have to really look. You have to keep looking. You have to look past the exterior. All of these people are insecure. They feed off one another to feel bad. Because why do you think they're all obese and unhealthy? It's no coincidence that's obese and unhealthy people harassing and stalking obese and unhealthy people. It's no fucking coincidence, man.
And themselves being the ultimate failure too.
I'd say not being able to adjust the light because you're on Section 8 is about the bottom of the barrel.
Disgusting. She's pathetic. It's cringy. Hilarious that she barely pulls any views anymore on her personal content.
Oh, I love this. You don't get numbers, so you're a bad person.
You're not the tea, boo. Your makeup is not the tea. And the fact that she's still talking that shit on Twitter when she hasn't lost a fucking pound at all, it's miserable. It's so cringy.
Who's desperate for attention again? I'm sorry. You've done talk shit about multiple people already. Who's desperate for attention? Hey, I didn't send for you, okay? You sent for me, yeah? You fucking sent for me, and I don't get sent for, but I'm here, all right? And I'm about to ruin this man's whole career.
So congratulations for still being a buffalo.
Yeah.
For Congrats. Not losing a stitch of fucking weight. Congratulations.
Why do you even need to say that? You know, man, like, I understand being petty, and I've been petty, but, like, I don't feel that way about ops. Like, whatever. She wants to be big, that's her choice, right? Like, you don't want to go out and get a job, so that's your choice, so what the fuck? Hey, ops, you should make a video about how she don't want to work.
Good on you. Moving on from that to, this did not come from Kiwi Farms, but tragic being booted off of YouTube. I am not going to shed a tear for that man. I think he's disgusting. I think he's a piece of shit.
Why?
And I don't believe a word that comes out of that pig's mouth. He is a pussy. He is not a real man whatsoever. Why? His obsession with children and child molesters and women is disgusting.
I'm going to stop you right there. I'm going to tell you what concerns me is that any of you all are concerned about people being concerned about inappropriate behavior around children. Okay? That's concerning me, Shaq. If I may appeal to your human side, why are you and others even commenting on that? You know what? That makes sense now. I know who you are in my Rumble comment section now. I'm glad I heard you say that because it's not more than one person. It's just you. You have a problem with it. I know who you are. I'm going to find that comment later. I know exactly who the fuck you are now. Shit. Tote on yourself.
Those pussy boy pictures on all the...
Oh, notice how she keeps using emasculating terms. Has she said a word about the things we're talking about Fancy Badger? No. She hasn't said anything about that. We've proven that. No, she won't talk about that. She wants to emasculate a guy she's obviously wants to fuck.
The pussy boy pictures, all of his pictures have got them filters on them. All the videos have got them filters on them. It's cringy. It's fucking pussy boy shit. little girls, teenage girls do that shit on their fucking photos and on their Instagram and Snapchats and shit. Not a grown-ass fucking man with kids.
Oh, yeah. So you know what else a grown-ass man with fucking kids does? By the way, Traj works a full fucking time job, take care of his family, while you sit at home not able to adjust the light because the government has to give you a handout. Okay, so while you're emasculating this man who sacrifices for his family, I want to remind you that the individual that we are talking about still makes videos of opening Pokemon cards to entice children to his channel, where he also covers the murder of children. He plays child video games and makes rape references. So excuse me if I'm a little concerned about allegations of child grooming from a motherfucker who has repeatedly had private viewings of other people's children's videos with a man who removes his shirt to sexualize himself to his audience while talking about children. Forgive me, Shaq, if the Section 8 ultraviolet light is fucking rotting your brain. I don't know what you're on about. You obviously are just like a jaded girlfriend, honey. You need to calm down. Nobody's going to have sex with you.
It's gross. He's gross.
Gross, pussy, gross. You made no point. Why? You said no reason. You hate him because he's gross and he's a pussy. Keep it to yourself then. I'm sure people look at you and go, damn, she's unattractive, but they don't run you down to call you a gross pussy, do they?
I get creepy fucking pedo vibes from him. The fact.
Oh, you do? Why?
The fact that he lied about me so effortlessly, talking about him having pictures of my pussy, saying that me and this Frank guy are dating, making a video saying that him and I are dating when I don't even fucking know him and never spoken a word to him. Knowing that Tragic can literally lie on people that effortlessly and then tell you that
you've proven nothing.
That you are obsessed with him, that you've talked about his children and that you've been stalking him for over a year.
Okay.
When you didn't even know he existed at all.
Okay.
In the world until he leached onto Ron like a fucking parasite.
Okay.
Nobody in Hater Nation knew who Tragic was, who knew who Yato, Frank, Dragnaut, none of these people even existed to all of us in Hater Nation until Tragic introduced this crew of people by slandering and defaming them.
No. No. Wow. Okay, cool. Wow. What is her deal? So you're on that shit now. You're on that shit right now. I'm gonna stop you right there. I'm not going to stop the video, but I'm going to stop right there for a second, Shaq. I want to let you know something. These people who you are going to bat for, I just want you to know that the optics of what you're about to do is irrational. Okay, one, not the optics. Let's leave that out right now. What you're about to do, I guarantee what you're about to do is irrational. And it's going to leave a stain on your reputation that is going to carry forward. It may not affect you now, but I promise you, you have to be careful about who you disavow and who you welcome into your fold. You understand? Again, I just cut ties with people that I've known for 30 years. You know why? Because they effortlessly allowed a pedophile to be around my family and didn't tell me. Because they vouched for the pedophile. And then I find out online that this dude had done 6 years in prison for molestation. So don't sit here and preach to me this virtuous horse shit. When I see something, when I see a grown man in his 30s and other grown men in their late 20s and 30s in a VR chat room saying, let me see your pee-pee. That's concerning. What would you call that, Shaq? Is that pussy boy shit? Is that gross pussy boy shit? Because you're getting ready to sign off on the guy that I just, that what I just described, you're about to sign off on the guy who did that. You understand that, right? I hope you're fully in touch with what you're about to do.
And having Ron as a mouthpiece. The Geek Room people are not associated with Hater Nation in any way, shape, or form. They don't talk about the same people as us at all. Never have. And Tragic is tragic. He is a tragedy. I believe that a lot of the stuff that comes out of his mouth is projection. I believe that the only people in life that take him seriously are young girls.
This now, I want to tell you right now, what you're doing right now is slander. You're being very slanderous, young lady. You are. But what can we take from you? I could probably come to your house and take that bolt out of that light so you can finally get some relief from that ultraviolet Section 8 lighting.
And he can't get a real woman. And I
wow, what does that? That has nothing to do with anything. You're just, you know what you're doing right now, and I'm going to go ahead and just tell you why this. You're going to see the stain on your reputation from me right now, because you are doing exactly what you are about to condemn later in this video. One, and two, you are signing off on people who multiple people who have been inappropriate around children and put it on their channels with a straight face. You have produced nothing on Tragic. You'd sit there in your dark bathroom with your camera off, your comments off, tell everybody they're desperate for attention. But here you are defaming this guy. Because why? Because the holidays are coming up. You need some ass pats and dopamine before you go and spend the taxpayers' money on some gift cards for your fucking family.
I said this to Nova the other day. Well, it's been more than the other day. It's been like 2 weeks. Like, the reason why he is so pressed and he is so bitter and angry about these guys having wives, like they're getting grown pussy every night, is that no real woman would give him any play. Like,
I'm going to ask you to kindly stop. To kindly stop. You're a slant. You are. Wow. Why are you single? See, I can make all kinds of assumptions as to why you are single. What if what you're saying right now is projection on your behalf? I believe it's projection, guys. I believe she's projecting because she's mad because Tragic won't sleep with her, because the only people who will sleep with her are underage boys. That's what she's trying to say. So I guess allegedly, I'll just say allegedly, and that makes it all right, right? Allegedly, Shaq sleeps with underage boys. She gives me pedo vibes. You know, I'm just going to say that now because I feel different about her. That's what you're doing, Shaq. You're like, oh, I feel different about him, so he's a pedophile all of a sudden. And then coming up, you condemn somebody who didn't even do something for something they didn't do.
Like, at all. The only people that would be attracted to somebody like that,
I'm gonna let
him
talk for a bit,
fucking shtick and that trash fucking music, is a 15-year-old little girl. That's it. And he's
honey, I assure you that 15-year-old girls have better taste than that too. Sorry. Everybody gets roasted here.
He's rage filled that every pussy that gives him attention comes with a fucking bid, and he's mad about it. So he's going to project all of that garbage onto other people. And I'm not going to let somebody like that perpetrate that type of shit on my channel ever in life. So I'm.
What are you talking about on your channel? You can't even leave a comment on your channel.
I'm glad that he's gone. He's disgusting. He's despicable. And it's gross the way Ron has fallen into that trap.
What trap are you talking about? You're literally signing off on people who have allegedly been inappropriate around children online. So, I mean, like, welcome to the fold, I guess.
It's
gross. You're gonna love it. You're gonna love it.
The whole VR chat room thing is not somebody being a child molester. Is it creepy and cringy? Yeah, it's creepy, but who gives a fuck? I've said and done.
Oh, filter on your face equals pedophile. Saying, let me see your pee-pee around little boys in a VR chat. Oh, it's cringy, but who gives a fuck? Did anybody else just catch that? How ridiculous this woman is. She is simping for individuals who have literally have multiple instances of being inappropriate around children. One guy makes videos about murdered children, lures them in with Pokemon card video. You know, you feel me? This is bullshit.
I've done some questionable things on online gameplay myself.
Really? Really? You've done some questionable things yourself. See, I told you it was projection. No, I want to go back. I want to hear that whole series of statements. So, okay, Shaq. So as long as it's in a video game, I can go up to you and be like, let me see your vagina. Hey, show me your vagina. That's okay. And with little kids around, right? You wouldn't condemn that. You'd upload it to your channel intentionally, right? But using a filter on a photo, oh, you're a pussy boy. You're a fuck boy. You're a pedophile, right? Kid, you don't see, dude, you're being manic. Remember that speech you gave me? And I'm not giving that to you just because I can. I'm giving it to you because you look real bad right now.
The whole VR chat room thing is not somebody being a child molester. Is it creepy and cringy? Yeah, it's creepy, but who gives a fuck? I've said and done some questionable things on online gameplay myself.
Good. I want her gamer tags. I do. I want her gamer tags. I'm going to scour YouTube, Xbox, PlayStation 4 for clips. She just admitted to doing and saying questionable things in gaming servers. I'm interested to see. She's willing to just dismiss, let me see your pee-pee. Oh, little boy's nearby. That's flanky, because she does it too. Because she does it too. No wonder you're vouching for these guys. Oh, Shaq. You are the gift that keeps on giving. Holy fuck.
I've talked to people like they're grown men. Come to find out when they turn their mic on, they're children. Was it sexual stuff? No. But I've definitely called what I thought to be a grown man out his name, and it turns out to be a child.
Oh,
because of the
sure.
shit that they were texting me.
Did you ask to see his pee-pee, though? That's what we need to know.
On the phone in GTA, I would assume that they were a grown-ass man. Doesn't make me a pedophile. And no. If you're going to allege that somebody was soliciting naked pictures from a minor, and then every single time you fucking tell the story, the person's age goes down by a year.
What are you talking? You don't even know what you're talking about. Fancy Badger Underhaven, one of the founders of the Geek Room, had an inappropriate relationship with somebody at the age of 13. They were 13 and they were like 17. This continued for 2 years. Do the fucking math. Nudes were exchanged and between both of them. Do the math. I played the videos where they confessed to it. Do your homework. You're going to go to Kiwi Farms and come over here and be like, beep, 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 beep. You're a pedo. Oh, you're just going to accuse somebody of a pedo, but you're a pedo for using a filter. Wow, bro. Wow. Go hug that fucking pit bull of yours and calm down.
I don't believe you at all. And because of the lies that you told about me right out the fucking gate when you didn't even know me at all, I don't believe a fucking word of it. So I'm hoping that these guys aren't really pedophiles and zoophiles, because with people like Tragic spreading that shit on the internet, consider the source. I need actual tangible proof of somebody being a zoophile or a fucking pedophile before I'm ever going to speak that shit out of my mouth.
Okay, you got one guy went online with a sex toy that was intentionally molded after a dog's genitalia. Okay. And laid claim to using it so much he punched a hole in it. So that's not normal. Okay. That's not troll shit, because this dude stalks people on the daily. He's up at 5 a.m. doing this stuff every day. You got another guy. Let me see your pee-pee. Hugging little boys in a VR chat, right? So, but it's okay. Hey, guys, who gives a fuck? Because Shaq has said and done some questionable things on the internet. Girl, I'd be scrubbing your Xbox shit. Because we gonna be looking now, because you just made me want to look.
Like, period. And then you have people like Peanut and Sylvana. They're so desperate for attention from Ron and Tragic and all these losers that they're literally going to perpetrate that same type of shit. And it's gross. It's
fuck it. One, don't loop Peanut in with me ever, okay? She wasn't there for me when the house of cards fell. She ain't there for me now. So leave her the fuck out of my circle, okay? Not part of it. Sylvana, on the other hand, ain't perpetrated anything. I said this at the beginning of the stream. This is why I wanted to do this, really, was because she lied about Sylvana. And look, man, you could think I'm a piece of shit, but Sylvana's not a piece of shit, okay? And you're not going to treat her like a piece of shit because your manic broke ass is mad about something. It sounds to me like you're pissed that Traj and Ron don't want to be your fake boyfriends on the internet. Is all you've done is gone on and on. You've went from trying to boost me up, saying I need to get help. I said, go fuck yourself. And now you're like, oh, well, his buddy's a pedophile because he uses a filter. But the guy I'm signing off on isn't creepy because, you know, I do shit online too. You fit right in with Nova. I'll tell you that. With that type of ideology, that's wokeology. That's exactly what that is. You know how I can say that? Why I can say that? It's because it's rules for thee, but not for me. Sylvana has never once perpetrated any of the allegations that I've made against other people. That's why I say allegedly. There is a alleged child grooming going on. There is the optics of it say alleged child grooming to me. Okay. She has never ran with any of that. She addresses what she sees on the screen. That's it. That's it, Shaq. You're in the dark insulting people's looks. You just telling people they're desperate for attention. You made this video to get my attention, Ops' attention, Traj's attention, Peanut's attention. Who else did she shit on at the beginning of the stream? You know what I'm saying? We're up to like five people now in this stream that you met. You made this stream, this video, to get five people's attention. Not a single one of us fucking sent for you. Not a single one of us asked what the fuck you thought. We don't care. I don't care. Your opinion means nothing. I'm telling you right now, there's 43 people watching this on YouTube. Who knows how many on Rumble. By 2 p.m., this will have twice as many views as your video does. That's how irrelevant you are. I guess it'll get mirrored on another channel too. So it's going to get more views there. I'm trying to let you know that your mental illness is showing right now. I'm not judging you for it.
As women, it's disgusting for you to even say that kind of shit.
Yeah, she's turning a blind eye to other people's behaviors and projecting that onto the people she doesn't like. That is some biased shit. This is not logical, objective thinking. She's being very, very subjective.
It's gross. And again, consider the source. You got two grown-ass men, fathers, that have no life. They spend 24/7 on the internet.
Wrong. I'm going to tell you something, Shaq. Where I'm sitting right now, I earned. Okay, I can go check my bank balance and look at what I've earned. There are no papers that I have to sign for the government to go, yes, you can eat this month. None of that. Okay, I have all my bills on auto pay because I don't have to micromanage my finances. So my grown children, they're 22 and 20 respectively. My youngest is going to be 14. He's at school till 2 o'clock every day. He comes home, he gets a snack, he goes to his room. I don't see him till dinner. Okay. And somehow, in all that time, I managed to clean two floors. I have to clean my floor up here because I do all my production, my shipping, my packing. Because, see, I still have a hustle outside of YouTube and Twitch and all that. This is really got kind of become a hobby. Like, Twitch is what I do for money, and this is what I do for a hobby, really. I pay to have this privilege to stream on Rumble, so it's a hobby. But tell me how I spend 24 hours a day. Traj has a job, a job, one of those things that allows you to sit there and eat for free in front of that fluorescent light in your bathroom.
Not getting any pussy whatsoever. Not getting any play on the internet from anybody that is remotely attractive.
Are you fucking kidding me? Are you kidding me? So you're telling me that you know every single female that he and I have ever talked to privately. How the fuck do you know that? That's scary. How do you know every correspondence we have privately with people? Let me alert you to something right now. Everybody doesn't go online and sling their poop everywhere like you're doing right now, okay? It just doesn't happen. And I'll have you know right now, somebody like you, if I were interested in somebody, I wouldn't make it public because somebody like you would find a way to fuck it up because that's how you operate. Listen to how jaded, jealous, salty, and bitter you are.
Any pretty bitch that confronts Ron, that is what is making him the nastiest. Like, that's what makes him rage, is when a pretty bitch puts him in his place.
Who?
And the only people that are left to suck his dick are the ugly hags and the old people that give him fucking super chats.
Wow. Oof. How do you know that? That's what I want to know. You sound just like MFW, doesn't she? She sounds just like Katie. How long did Katie sound like this? Katie sounded like this for years.
Old hags, ugly old bitches. It's just the ugly fat bitches.
Okay, honey. Okay, baby girl. Okay. If I knew people could not act like a fucking idiot for 5 minutes, I would show your ass next year when we all get together. But I ain't gonna do that. Because fuck everybody. They got shit to prove to none of y'all. I know people. I know what they look like. And anyway, who the fuck cares what they look like? Do you have a full body mirror in your house by chance? Do you? That you sat here with your camera off, chain smoking in your welfare bathroom, judging ops looks, people you don't know, their looks. Like, honey, you're being manic.
And that's why he's so mad, though. Because these other guys, they get pussy every single night if they want it.
Who? Who? What other guys? You talking about Flanky from Crude as Fuck? No. Tell me what guys get pussy every night that are in a VR chat going, show me your pee-pee with other dudes.
They have real wives that love them, and these two fucking clowns have literally nobody besides...
Yeah, I'm gonna go play, show me your pee-pee with 30-year-old dudes, and they go, fuck my wife.
A gaggle full of losers on the fucking room. It's pathetic. So, am I shedding a tear? For losing his platform, absolutely fucking not.
Yeah, you were in your last video. Shut up.
YouTube is not the place for slander and defamation. I don't believe a word that came out of his mouth.
You just slandered and defamed Tragic. God, the self-awareness is off the chain here, buddy. Off the fucking chain.
I don't care who believes it. I don't. And I don't even know these guys. I've never spoken to these two guys a day in my life. I've never been in a live stream that they've been in. Never met them. Never spoken a word to them. I don't follow them on social media, but the little...
Okay, we get it. But you're sitting here talking about them. You don't follow it, but you're going to sit here and make accusations. Oh, no,
clips
keep going.
And bits and pieces of proof that I've seen doesn't prove a fucking thing.
Oh, you're talking about the weirdos that you're signing off on. No, I want you over there with them. I do. Like I said, you fit right in with Nova. These are her people. And apparently your people, too. You know the type of people I'm talking about, right? You know why? You know what I'm talking about.
It just proves that people are reaching and they're desperate to slander somebody else to deflect away from what's going on with them. And
what's going on with me? Ain't nothing going on with me.
And I'm not buying into it at all. So, moving on from that.
Okay, cool. What's the next subject? Can we stop? Is she done? Is she done?
I think that this is the last thing that I was going to talk about was cool. Young Dumb Honey Bun.
I don't want to hear this shit. That's dumb. Wow, you're a slanderous little hussy. That's crazy how slanderous. That's crazy. You just condemn people for what you just did. Do you understand that? That every single thing you just said, it applies to everything you just said. What can you say to that, dude? I like how we've had people mad that we look good if we post a picture in Discord, but people are also mad that we're ugly. Which is it? Fuck them. You know what I'm saying? That was just some manic shit. She makes no sense. I mean, if Los was right about one thing about Shaq, that is, trash. I saw her thumbnail when I was looking for a picture of this individual. Hey, I will split the screen up again because that's the only way you can see my name. There you go. I am the Section 8 bully, baby. We're all ugly. Yeah, she's a catch, guys. You know what I look for in a woman? One, must have a cat and a pit bull because I fucking love both. Oh, man, I love cats and pit bulls. God damn. There's nothing turns me on more than other animals' pheromones overpowering my female's pheromones. You know what I'm saying? Nothing more. Two, unemployed. Yeah, not underemployed. Completely fucking unemployed. No income. $0. You get nothing. Three, complete welfare dependency. That's right. I gotta take my glasses off for a little bit, man. Since Shan can't see me.
You can't see me squinting, can you?
So if you're a broke bitch, is what I'm saying. Hey, hit your boy up. I need another dependent. Yeah. You know what I'm saying? I need another dependent. I do. I mean, I've already got one. I could use another one. God damn, Trage, take it easy. save some roast for everybody else. What kind of ass pats is she getting from that video? She has to log in to see everybody giving it a thumbs down. I bet more people have already seen it now than have watched her video. Yeah, I'd take them off, Shan. My focus is off. I don't know. I really got to redo my setup. I got to back everything up. And I got to clean everything today anyway because we're having company Friday and Saturday. So I got to clean the house from, well, I mean, upstairs is clean. All I do is sleep, fart, and get on the internet up here. So the downstairs, you know, you got to do all that jazz. And I clean the kitchen every night anyway because I cook. Hey, Red, what's going on? So, I don't know what Shaq, what her point was, but she just simped for crude as fuck. And that's great. Hey, Frank. That's one you want on your side, man. I promise you, she won't pretend to be your friend for years. And then when you do one thing she doesn't like or you don't, you know, give her the attention she wants, she won't turn on you. I promise. She won't go out and insinuate that you're a pedo because you use a filter. All right? I just want you to know that. Yeah, I'm not going to listen to her talk about Young Dumb Honey Bun. She had the balls to sit here and act like she's some kind of fucking Keemstar Trisha Paytas hybrid. Making an important video about people and then saying, you're desperate for attention. Like I could do this stream and it'll segue into some kind of profit for me down the line. That's the way I look at it. You should always invest your time in something. You invested like 22 minutes in crying about everybody else doing better than you. That's what I heard. You talk about everybody else's shit being projection. All you did was sit there and project, honey. I may have bought my Christmas, a lot of it, on credit, but I also know that if I needed to, in 5 fucking minutes, without hesitation, I could pay all those credit lines off. Okay? So don't come on here and fucking preach to me about anything ever again. You have proven yourself to be, incoherent, intellectually dishonest, nasty, seething, and 100% untrustworthy. You proved that when you went on Nova Flakes stream and just threw everybody under the bus because, why not? She feels connected to me. This is why I'm not leaving my state. I'm not going anywhere near any of these women from the internet. Are you fucking kidding me? Is my carry permit honored in your state? Well, cool. I'm telling you, that's just, I'm not leaving my state because I could carry my firearm in my state. I don't trust people. And I know we live in a society where people think that that's a threat. How is that a threat saying I'm going to defend myself? That's fucked. That's a threat telling me you think that's a threat. So, okay, I won't say it. Just assume that it's a fact. Should people just wear a shirt that says, try me, motherfucker? I've never fucked with anybody I thought carried. I don't fuck with people, period. That's dumb. But especially, you know, if somebody's carrying a weapon, you don't fuck with people, man. They're people that people will kill you for nothing. You know, they'll kill you over nothing. You'd buy that shirt? I'm gonna write that shit down. I need to start making some shirts for the new year. If I sell one, that'll be fine. Yeah, I don't know what Shaq wants from us, man. She's not getting that. She's not getting my twig and berries. No, I'm not down with that, dude. No, man, no. I dodged a broke bitch last time I tried to date. That's been months. Remember the girl? Some of y'all know I told you about her, right? Remember she was like, we had a time planned like days in advance and it came time for that day. And then like, she was like, she canceled and then gave me some story about her roommates and her medicine. And I was like, yo, I'm out on this. So I knew by then when she said medicine, I said, yo, I don't want nothing to do with this shit. I know what kind of baggage comes with people who have roommates and controlled substances, you know, that are prescribed. You know, she had a bunch of pills, you know. So, God fucking damn it. A homosexual, yeah. So once one of these fucking broke bitches gets their claws in you, I'm not a simp. First and foremost, understand this. Yeah, pussy's great. Oh, love it. But who's it attached to? You know what I'm saying? Like, I could get one that's not attached to anything and throw it in a drawer when I'm done. So, like, I don't, you know, if I'm gonna have a vagina that's attached to somebody, I want it to have a soul that's conducive with mine and my journey on this planet. Yeah, she still thought the date was on. She called me and said, okay, I'm ready. And I was like, what? I done canceled this shit, bitch. You talk about? What do you mean you're ready for what? You want me to send my homie over, Sloppy Seconds? Fuck, I mean, it's named Sloppy Seconds, bro. Well, I don't know. Maybe she did. Maybe that's what she had to do before she left. She had to fuck somebody in an apartment. I don't know. I can't believe Shaq's signing off on these degenerates. She has no idea. It just goes to show she does none of her research. She's completely emotional and irrational. It's sad, really. It really is, because it's the holidays and she's really manic. I feel for her family. They're going to have to deal with this, you know? Is there a possibility she may be autistic a little bit? I mean, I am. So, well, I mean, there's no... I mean, well, when I say autistic a little bit, what I mean is, like, you're autistic, but, you know, it's... Fuck, I don't know. Maybe everybody's autistic. Who cares? Right? Who cares? Right? Like, what's her name? Anorexic Bean, the Allie Dean, or whatever the fuck her name is. Skeletor's lost chromosome. What's with these people? Like, big fans of mine. Just come out and say it. Just say you're a fan. I will welcome you into my bosom. I'm a good guy. You think hundreds of people followed me off the platform because I'm an asshole? No. Why don't you go yeet French Fry Girl real quick and see how well she fares on Twitch and Rumble? Do it. Go do it. Do it now. Hey, Traj, watch what that one comment does. That's all I'm going to say. Yeah, Silvana, you make one or two videos. It's okay because Shaq takes a week off and then just talks shit about everybody in one video. Instead of doing a video every day, she just makes one 20-minute video talking shit about everybody. It's different, guys. Yeah, desperate for attention. Do they not know how YouTube works? Why did you put it on YouTube then? If you weren't, she's desperate for attention because she put it on YouTube. What the fuck kind of logic is she using? I feel a certain way, so therefore it's black and white thinking. Then she claimed that she was BPD as well, and I'm connected to nags, and I can relate. Black and white thinking, Han. You know that's what it is. I'll tell you this right now. People don't have to be desperate for attention. They don't. The people who are desperate for attention are the ones that do the videos, the ones who go to my Rumble channel and comment ridiculous shit every day, multiple times a day. That's scary that you have that much time, one. That shit. Those are the ones that are desperate for attention, Shaq. You, Drag, Frankie. Like, Frankie's out here flagging people, right? Who? Well, I don't normally do these guys. And then his community is ragging on everybody else who copyrights them. It's a big deal if you do it to them, but oh, let's shut your tail down. Those are the people you're signing off on. Good Lord. Have fun. It's exactly where you belong. Mental illness of that level ends up pulling up in just one little coagulated puddle of shit anyway, with a thin skin. Like milk. She took a week break from social media and kiwi farms. I can't believe it, Miss Lava Lamp. I can't believe it. How does she have, I can't believe she has the willpower to do it. I mean, I just feel, oh, I envy this individual. Yeah, the people who are desperate say, fuck it, who cares if this guy was playing show me your pee-pee around little boys in a VR chat and uploaded it to his channel with Pokemon video openings or Pokemon card openings. Yeah, who cares? She does questionable shit, too. She said it herself. She confessed to doing questionable shit. It's one thing to fuck up. I mean, like, but questionable? Are you serious? Questionable, like, kind of removes the I didn't know factor. You understand? Like, because if you didn't know, it wouldn't be questionable. Now, would it? You'd be like, well, I didn't know. I fucked up. Yeah, okay, you fucked up. Now that it's questionable means you went into it and acted a certain way that people could judge one way or another, and you didn't care. Damn trash. She was stuck in the laundry room for a week. Yeah, the dog was pregnant. She lived off the milk. It's a story as old as... It's a story as old as time. I make it way too easy, guys. Yeah, I'm not going to sit by and let a former friend of mine sit there and fucking slander me and my people I do consider my friends. All right. So, I mean, she's irrelevant and I could have just ignored it because nobody really gives a fuck and nobody can comment on it anyway. So, but I figured why not? I'm going to leave this up on YouTube. I've not been a bad boy. Okay. I'm going to stay in chat for a few, but. Hitting the bong like I bet I'm hitting the bong like somebody who doesn't have to worry about where his next bag comes from. I'm gonna keep the live stream up and everybody gets roasted. Yeah, I'm gonna leave the stream up here and on Rumble, but I'm very interested to see what the comments are on YouTube. I want to know what people think about this. She won't let people say anything. Fuck it. You know she's going to watch this because she's on Kiwi Farms. She hasn't taken her break yet. She's going to unsubscribe from Becky after the first of the year, guys. Better go tell Becky. Becky! Shaq's going to unsubscribe. He's taking his Papa John's sponsorship elsewhere. My wallet up. If you saw this little water pipe I have, you don't fucking, you want to come up here and suck it like a dick? You're gonna take a big drink? Fuck, this thing isn't 6 feet long. it takes one little half draw to fill it up. Jesus Christ. Hell, let me deep throat it. Hey, let me just deep throat it and break it in my throat. I'm a pothead. It's not meth, it's not crank, right? Calm the fuck down. All right? It's weed. Hey, I make a hat. You know why I call it that? Because you can't call it a bong in a shop here. You can't. They're not supposed to. Absolutely not. Because a bong is a term for paraphernalia. And I understand that THC is legal here, but it's a water pipe. I refer to it that around my family, too. What's that, water pipe? Nobody ask a question. If you say it's a bong, they start asking questions. It's a fucking water pipe. Leave me alone. Piss off. I got a bag of tobacco over here. He said he flagged out a video for calling him an incel. Yeah, most pedo sympathizers are pretty thin-skinned. You're talking about the guy who created a whole fictitious sexual scenario involving me, a woman, and my child, who at the time was 8 years old. That's who we're talking about. That's how he's thin-skinned for a reason. Why do you think this dude, like, okay, hey, Shaq, you want to talk about something? How about the Marcel Becker Predator Project or whatever it is? You want to talk about projection? This dude created a scenario where he wants to believe that I had sex in front of my underage child while he was 8 years old. And he says I had sex with MFW in the front seat of her car while he was in the back seat in the parking lot 10 feet from my apartment door where there were two bedrooms. This is what he claims. So there you go, Shaq. I love it that you signed off on all these guys. I love it. Yeah, boy. They run in packs, Traj. They run in packs like wolves. They have to. Real men stand alone, bruh. Real men stand alone. These guys, as to quote Shaq, they on that pussy boy, fuck boy shit. Oh, and let it be known that if you're a guy, you use a filter ironically or even unironically, that makes you a pedophile immediately to Shaq. Yeah. Not co-signing guys who play let me see your pee-pee in video games, because she does questionable things too. I'm just giving you a rundown, like a little bit of a checklist from what we just watched. I'm going to drive it in your head that this is what we are witnessing. This is what we have witnessed. Yeah, the Draven guy said he drove by my house. Yeah, the guy that DC Media Girl had on as a mod, who's also a friend of Loaf's. Yeah, all the people who are stalking and harassing me on a daily basis. Yeah, those people. It'd be great if some of them had a criminal record. That's the problem, but they don't leave their fucking house. So it's hard to get a criminal record when you don't leave your house. Yeah, they say you use face filters when you're not. Dude, she's just salty, bruh. He was naming his physical attributes. Jesus. Jesus Christ, what is going on, man? These guys know that I'm not going to fuck them, right? They understand that, right? Traj and I aren't going to run a train on them. It's not going to happen. I know we're attractive and charismatic and all that shit, but what I need you to do is to dial it back a notch, big homie. All right? I'm sure there's a nightclub nearby or something that caters to your fetishes. I'm not kink shaming. Do what you want. Get your nut, boy. Get your nut. Just get it in a different way. Put a shirt on. Wait till you get in the club to take it off, okay? I'm sure they're used to seeing 350-pound men with double D tits. We call him sexual chocolate. Meow. I don't give a fuck about filters. I don't give a fuck about Shaq and her fucking head of lettuce either. I gotta do nothing to get none of these fools heated except exist, because they know people like me don't give a fuck and they'll call their shit out. They're used to running roughshod over people. Look, they keep trying to silence people. If you're innocent, why are you silencing your accuser for? What are you doing that for? Why do you need the evidence removed? Why do you need to silence somebody over something that you put on the internet? Yeah? You're not making any money off of it, so you're not doing it to protect your intellectual property. You're doing it to remove something from the internet. Dude, it's never going to go away. That clip, let me see your pee-pee clip and giving people hugs in a VR chat with children, that's never going away. I mean, if it takes a lifetime of making people like this uncomfortable legally, online, maybe they won't do the shit that people are. Maybe we're stopping something before it advances. I still think individuals like this should be completely fucking deplatformed, though. I support that 100%, because that's not protected by the First Amendment. Hugging children in virtual reality and going up to your adult buddy going, show me your pee-pee! Show me your pee-pee! The fuck is that? Oh, that's Flank! Shit. I felt you on that one. I felt you on that one, homie. I'm trying to keep it real so I keep this replay up, man. I need the watch time. I need a watch time. I'm Section 8 Bully. Check me out. Hey! Hey, hey! Section 8, what? Section 8, what? Come at me. Come at me. What? the Fwank is saying, give your pick. That's right, Miss Lava Lamp. You know this. You're a rational thinking human being. You get it. No, Fwank is petty. He is a hypocrite, full on hypocrite. It's unreal to watch him operate. He says one thing and means a complete other. He does. And then somehow he makes himself the victim, and that justifies him being a hypocrite somehow in his head. He stands for nothing. He has no convictions. You know what I'm saying? I've only seen him defend people who are fucking foul and vile. I've only ever seen him attack people who are either sick, you know, on a different level. You know what I'm saying? He's always trying to punch down. And then as soon as somebody hits him back, he cries and he goes and he flags stuff. He doesn't want anybody to have a voice. And that's why I'm saying these people may be irrelevant, but dude, if they're going to do it to you, they're going to do it to somebody else. So fuck them. Fuck them. Think I give a fuck about making thousands of dollars right now? Well, I mean, I do. I'd be nice to make thousands of dollars, but fuck this shit. I'm not going to be silenced by the law being abused. I'm not going to be silenced by the law being abused. Just to think he used to be friends with that feller. Yeah, if I were in a VR chat and children were in there like, give me a hug, I'd be like, dude, I'm out the fuck. I'm fucking out of here. That ain't my kid. I'm out. And not even that. What if it's fucking some other weirdo posing as a child? So what's really going on in these chats, dude? These VR chats, you understand? That's some fuck shit. That's, you're in VR to live a fantasy, correct? So your fantasy is to hug strange children and see somebody's pee-pee? is nobody else making that? You uploaded it to your, I'm blown away, he uploaded it to his channel and he's striking people for it. It is so bizarre. Thank you, Trash. Yeah, it is what you want to do in your fantasies, right? So if you go into VR chat, start hugging strange children, well, stay the hell away from kids in Walmart, I guess. You feel retarded. And as you should. No, I'm just kidding. A kid. Is it excessive that I have both a firearm and a hammer next to me? The hammer is not a weapon, by the way. I was working on something. I was just asking if it was excessive. Yeah, that's evidence of something being there. Yeah. Yeah, absolutely. You got to stay on motherfuckers like this because they will silence you. That's how it works, dude. Look, watch mainstream media. That trial with that jizz on my back lane lady, Epstein's gimp. Yeah. I'm sorry. Where's this list of elitists that were on this? You know what I'm saying? Like, what we peasants don't get to see. See, there are no countries and everything. The world is run by just one entity, and it's a few people who just do whatever the fuck they want. People are trying to silence me with fucking stupid state laws that shouldn't even be applicable to anyone outside of their jurisdiction. Especially the fucking internet. Especially something that was never sent. Especially copyright laws that don't exist, so some creep can remove evidence of his transgressions. That's what he's doing. It's not being condemned by anyone else but myself. And hey, we've both been silenced. We've had to sneak in the back door. Yeah? So fuck that. grooming. I'm telling why else? Why else is an adult interacting with strangers' children in a VR chat on the same channel where he makes Pokemon unboxing, where his whole background is children's toys? There's nothing adult back there, fellas. I get it that Pokemon is for all ages, but fuck me, bro. Come on. Come on. Why else would a grown man cater to children so much? And I can't believe you do that and then throw in some child murder videos and this woman stomping on children's graves, figuratively, of course. I'm just saying, do I have collectibles? Yeah, I have some Funko Pops. I have one that somebody had made custom for me. I have a Pee Wee Herman, a Missy Vaughn, and I think I have a Joker. And they're in my bookcase over there. They're for display. And there's some vitamins sitting on the same shelf with them. my toys have gunpowder, baby. My toys are steel and are surgically sharp. My toys go bang. My toys go beep, boop, beep. My toys go blah, 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 blah. My toys go, yes, daddy. Oh, shit. Separate rooms, huh? Well, hey, it do be like that sometimes. I ain't never getting married. I'm sure as fuck, I'm the man of this house. Ain't nobody kicking me the fuck out of anywhere.
Go sleep in another room.
Fuck you. Go, you go sleep in another room. I bet you go sleep in another zip code. Even better. Uber, Uber. Dum, dum. Guys, again, if you want to support this channel, thenegativenation.com or $NEGZNN Cash App.
Appreciate it.
My son, he collects a lot of Funkos and he collects Pokemon stuff. He's 13. He's a 13-year-old boy. He collects Pokemon. He put it on display like is he remedial, like, for real? Because, like, I always feel like I'm really punching down, or this dude is just don't give a fuck. He's gonna openly do whatever the fuck he wants, and he's gonna just be a little bee about it and report you and cry and moan and piss and get his woke squad to gang up on you and harass you and send you emails and cease and desist. Yeah. I don't know. I'm just saying, you got to keep your eye open. Keep an eye on your kids. Well, I'll just tell you, man, that I'm sus of a 30-something-year-old man who has nothing but toys decorating his backdrop while he's covering somebody who exploits the deaths of children and then also goes into VR chats and does, you know, let me see your pee-pee shit. It's really fucking sus, bruh. And I guarantee if my son is still into Pokemon at 18, then fuck it. Whatever. You know what I'm saying? I'm not going to judge him on that. But if he's 34 and his whole backdrop is... I mean, like, who the fuck is that big of a Pokemon fan? This dude likes horror movies and shit. Pokemon! I like the Pokemon! It's like he just discovered it or something. I like the Pokemon! I picked it to my favorite Pokemon! Do you like Pokemon too? I like the Pokemon! Oh, he's 32. Wow. Big boy. I like the pizza too.
Oh, Frankie, you're drooling all over yourself. Come here, you little... God damn it.
And my TikTok's not doing too bad. Yeah, I saw them do that earlier, Jana. I don't know what the hell that is. It must be some kind of code to, like, spam chats or some shit. Who knows? Or maybe it's something so they can save the chat. It's probably a Kiwi farmer.
I must save this chat. It's relevant to my existence. I must appear superior to the other shitlords.
He does look older than me. That's crazy. And I got almost 13 years on this dude. Almost 13 years. He never considers that when he insults me. Oh, yeah, and Wet for Murder. I forgot about Wet for Murder. Thank you. I forgot about that. Yeah, I forgot. I told Reaper, thank you. Yes, they also, in this same clip, told a kid that they were wet for murder. A child was wet for murder. Yes, that's what they said. To a child. Jana, no, hide them. Yes, no, I don't give a fuck who it is. Hide them. You don't need to be putting that shit in my chat. And fuck off. I look forward to his LOL suit. I do. I look forward to show. I look forward to it because, you know, countersuits are a thing. Like, just because you say a bunch of shit and somebody says one fucking thing to you doesn't mean that you're not guilty of shit. Just means now your transgressions get to be seen as well. Dummies. God. Ha ha! You gotta go to jail! Oh, really? Is that just how it works? I forgot this was Nazi Germany. They're going to come vaccinate me and take me to the gulag. I don't encourage any trolling of any type. Because... just because I don't. I don't want to be... Because I got enough... Dude, I got enough of people encouraging it. 150 screenshots to the DA worth... of people encouraging others to go out report me, which, you know, or to say something or for over nothing. I didn't do anything. It was complete hyperbole and irresponsible of somebody to use their platform like that. Now, their platform is receding rapidly, but it's still an inappropriate use. And look, you can't just punish everybody around you who's your critic. You don't get to do that and then just do whatever you want. Fuck that. Censorship? That's what we're doing now. We're censoring people. I want you to understand this. This may seem like a futile a statement to make or point to make, rather, but look at how the government's functioning along with the mainstream media right now, and along with Twitter. Twitter is suspending accounts covering the Ghislaine Maxwell trial. Whatever, Jillian, jiggle my boobs, Maxwell trial, whatever the fuck her name is, the pedophile. They're removing accounts on that. They're removing accounts that are critical of vaccinated people or unvaccinated people. It's crazy. You can't talk about anything that's not the fucking narrative. You can't, because they just will just censor you. Fuck it. We'll shut them down. We'll send them. We'll make sure they don't have anybody to tell. Like, really? Wow. Really? That's what we're doing now? Crude as fuck, censored, tragic, because he didn't like something that he uploaded to the internet. Let me repeat that so you understand. Crude as fuck flagged tragic because tragic uploaded a clip that crude as fuck had previously uploaded and deleted because it was called out for the sus behavior. Okay? He flagged tragic and silenced him because of this clip that crude as fuck intentionally edited out of an entire gaming stream and uploaded to his channel intentionally, along with his Pokemon unboxing videos, his oh, look at the woman exploiting child murder videos, his look at the woman abusing her children videos, that stuff. So he, tragic's the one who needs to be silenced, right? I'm the one who needs to be silenced. Oh, we have opposition to our delusions? We better shut that shit down. How do they think censoring anybody helps a goddamn thing? Did you ever think for a hot second that when you censored me, you censored hundreds of other people and that pissed them off? Oh, I got an idea. I know what I'll do. My feelings are hurt. I'll put a target on my back on the internet. That's a figure of speech, by the way, you fucking snowflakes. Figure of motherfucking speech. Look into it. Yeah, I'll just put a target on my back online. Because that seems like a good idea. I'll just censor people who call me out on my lies. Ridiculous, ain't it? Must censor everybody, right, Charlie Gold? YouTube, manual review. Manual review, YouTube. I don't want to hear that in here, Red. I'm going to put you in timeout. I don't want to hear that. I don't want to hear. Keep it to yourself. Because see, now you're going to fucking hit me. You're going to make it look like I fucking encourage that shit. People take your shit out of context. Fuck that. Don't threaten to do nothing. I haven't even seen you in months. Don't. Because I'll just yeet you, okay? I have to make an example because I have to make it clear that I'm not on any fuck shit. All right? I stay in my fucking lane. I talk about what I see on the screen. That's it. I haven't done anything before. There's no evidence of anything I've done before. So please, I ask you nicely. Don't do your fucking petty plotting and scheming elsewhere. I don't want to hear anything about fucking docs. I don't want to hear anything about fucking families. I don't want to hear anything about names. I don't want to hear anything about addresses or fucking phone numbers. I don't want to hear about grandma, grandpa, screenshots. I don't want to hear nothing. I want to see it on my screen and I want to talk about it. That's it. Period. Trolling somebody. Now you've told everybody in the chat that you're going to do that. So I just want to make it clear. That wasn't me. I don't sign off on that shit. Like Shaq over here signing off on these creepy guys in the VR chat. Once you publicly announce something like that, like what the fuck? What do you think this is? A hug box? Like the chat. Look on the screen. Look on the fucking screen. It doesn't matter. If somebody's recording the screen, they have the chat. I do that intentionally to keep people honest. Okay? You have an opinion? Great. Fantastic. God damn it. I can't remove it from I don't know how to remove it. Hey man, what you do outside this chat is on you, but right here I gotta keep it 100. Okay, I gotta keep it 100. If it's on the screen and if I believe in my heart of hearts that what I'm saying is everything I say is allegedly, these are all allegations. If people don't like it, then stop doing shit that the optics look bad on, you know what I'm saying? But please keep your fuck shit to yourself. Like, even if you're in a Discord, you feel like you're on some fuck shit, just create a private thread between you and the other fuck shitters. You feel me? Just create a thread. Create a thread with you and the other fuck shitters. Never say anything publicly, or I'm privately willing to say publicly, and never say anything publicly that you're not willing to own up to later. You're good, Nikki. Don't worry. Yeah, Death, it's fine. I'm here to give an opinion and move on. Is being censored a serious offense? Yes. But I also have a life. You understand what I'm saying? All I can deal with is what's on the screen. That's it. That's it. I'm not taking anything, anybody's real to front door. No, 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 no. Nor have I ever. Nor will I ever. Yeah, well, one thing I'm not even concerned about anymore as far as my future commentary goes is any of the past transgressions involving my family, because that's a distraction to the to what's happening, to the bigger picture. I can protect what's in front of me. What I can't protect is what I can't see. I can only try to prevent. You feel me? I'm not telling anybody what to do. It's your family. I'm not telling anybody. Look, man, I will never tell anybody how they deem, what kind of defense they deem fit for their family, nor would I ever tell a man. I would just always tell a man to use reason, because if your family's young, even if they're not young, they need you. They need you. That's it. If you could kill two birds with one stone, if you could expose some fuck shit, And let people be known to these type of individuals, then great. But no, at what cost? My mouth in defending my children has gotten me in trouble. I've never done anything to anybody physically. I've never traveled. Let me make this abundantly clear. I would never do anything that would take me away from my children. And nor would I let anybody do anything to me that's going to take me away from my children. But I still have to be here. It's a pretty chill day today. I had a good time in the stream. There is nothing scheduled for tonight on Twitch, but that doesn't mean that I won't be live on Twitch. So, but you know me, I'm on the internet 24/7. I might go lock myself in my welfare bathroom and stare into the infinity light and chain smoke Marlboro menthols on the taxpayer's dime. All right, guys, much love from me to you. That's me thumping my chest like a man. Take it on the chin. Be a man. Love you. I'll see you later. Bye-bye.